Therefore, we can use it to our advantage. We can open our doors, the church house, also to invite people in so we can show them some love, as you were stating earlier. We can also give them scripture, but not to the point where we're going to beat them down.
Correct.
But yes, to, to show it from the Lord's perspective, and then for us to gain a soul. Because I believe, too, it is that time for us to witness.
So you're saying that you're going to witness to me?
Yes.
Witness about what? What is witnessing?
Oh, I see. You're trying to be controversial.
Okay, yes, well, if you're going to dress up as a witch on Halloween, come to my house. You'll be so blessed.
Really? How am I going to be blessed if I come to your house?
If you come, I just said that. If you're going to come to my house as a witch, I usually ask them, what are they dressed up as? Why did they choose that particular character? And then I offer them candy, and I offer them a track, and I hug them and say, see you next year. That's what I do, because I know that those, primarily the parents, I'd be a little shocked to see a grown-up girl like you come to my door as a witch. But then again, they were shocked last year when they came into my door and I was dressed up as God's Gothic girl.
Yeah.
So, you know, it was the same kind of persona. But when they came, they were, I reached out to them with the love of God and with the word of God. So the point I'm trying to make is that I don't think this is a time where we as Christians can go into a Christian shell. I don't think that's going to be appropriate. This, we're living in a sexting, texting, Starbucks generation. And so in my opinion, it's important to jump into the dialogue.
Right.
And not necessarily to, I mean, those of us who have been around a while, who, you know, this isn't our first rodeo, we know some of the history of Halloween. We know historically what it is, and we know as Christians to stay far, far away from that mentality and that pagan celebration. However, that's not what those little kids are thinking when they come and knock on your door. They don't know what we know about the scriptures. So I don't lock and bolt my door on that night, and nor do I say I'm not going to participate in this pagan ritual. I open my door because I know that for most who are celebrating that night, they're coming, they want to dress up in the costumes. Why wouldn't they? Because they go into Walmart, they see rows and rows and rows and rows of these fun things to put on, or spooky things. In their opinion, that's going to be fun stuff. Another thing you can't do is you can't erase Harry Potter.
Yeah.
And Harry Potter is the number one best-selling books in this decade. So you can't erase that. You can't erase that influence.
No, you can't.
So I think because of Harry Potter and things like that, it has emerged this celebration of a dark side.
We have kind of been separatists. We have taken a separatist mentality, basically, on Halloween. And like you said, now, if you come to my door and you're a witch, Harriet, I'm going to lay hands on you. It's like, come along. Y'all ain't right. But Gina's making a valid statement. And we, and I know when I raise my children, one thing what I really liked that when I raised the children, they started having harvest festivals and hallelujah festivals, because at that time our nation had gone to such a stream that it wasn't safe anymore to let the children trick-or-treat. Remember, we all trick-or-treated, I think, as a child. Remember, we used to get bags and bags of candy, and and everybody was kind, but remember then they started putting razor blades and poison. So that's one reason that I took my kids to a safe environment, because, you know, it was safe, you know, now.
But, you know, you know, Masha, not to cut you off, but really as a child, I really didn't trick-or-treat.
Okay.
My grandmother didn't allow us to do it.
Was it because of the religion, or because of it was just too dangerous?
I really don't know. Yeah. She was not, you know, a lot of things she didn't let us do. And so I guess she was like from the old school. So a lot of things she didn't let us, you know, get involved in. I wanted to trick-or-treat, but I couldn't. And then, like, when Pastor Betty was saying about the church and opening the church, I remember we did with our young people at church, we talked about Halloween and talked about the costumes and mm-hmm. the meaning of the different costumes and why they were going to be who they were going to be. Mm-hmm. And then we also told them that if they were going to go out, like Pastor Gina is saying, if they were going to go out, we taught them to not to say trick or treat. Mm-hmm. We taught them to say trunk or treat. Mm-hmm. So what that we would do is we would give them all trikes.
Mm-hmm.
We flipped it. Mm-hmm. We would give them all trikes, and we would let them take a trike and knock on the door. You know, if they knocked on the door, they would give the family who housed mm-hmm. they knocked on the door mm-hmm. a trike. Mm-hmm. So what it was a tool to witness, and it was a tool to bring people mm-hmm. into mm-hmm. the church, you know, because I'm reminded where it says, with love and kindness mm-hmm. have I drawn thee. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so mm-hmm. so I do agree that when you say about opening, you know, the church, the doors,